好，今天我们来看看关于这个 object part 2。有很多人呢，就是当他看到这个 object part 2的时候呢，他只是限于说明关于那个东西的 function 或者是 characteristic。所以很多时候呢，你可能就会停留在这个 function， 就是说完了大约一分钟，不知道要说什么了。所以物体类的东西呢，或者是这种的 topic 呢，其实有很多方面你可以去了解的。比如说你可以从那个 feelings， 就是这个东西是不是很 special for you， OK。 Another one is it something that you'd use on a daily basis? So it makes your life very convenient and makes your life easier， 对吧？所以你不能 you can't live without this particular object。 然后另外一个你可以对比一下 culture， 就是旧或者是新的。所以呢，这种的物体类呢，试着去从不同的那个direction， 不同的观点去看一看这种的题目。那么呢，今天的这一个课呢，我们会讲解的就是 describe a piece of furniture。比如说这样子这个 topic 呢，它只是说 describe a piece of furniture， 后面其实是我加进去的。所以你看到这个 topic 的时候，你可以自己再加一些 condition。Is it a furniture that you like, or is it a piece of furniture that you often use?Or is it a piece of furniture that is really special to you? 对吧？所以试着去串这种的event， 就是关于 feelings， 或者是你是常常用的吗？或者是对你来说，这个是联想到某个事件类的吗？对吧？所以不要只是说物体类，就是要形容那个物体，可以从其他的方面去讲解这个题目，帮助你去延展。So let's take a look at 我们的这个大纲。所以在这个两分钟里面呢，我会先把它安排成 introduction, reason, and reason, because I have two reasons why I would like to talk about this piece of furniture, okay? And then here, what I'm going to talk about is a piece of traditional furniture in my country, 就是那个藤,藤的椅子,我们叫它为 rattan chair. 然后另外一个是介绍一下我是从哪里购买这个椅子的，然后呢，在家的话，我就说它的那个 function 就是基础的，然后另外一个是关于那个 old versus new， 就是从那个culture 那边那个观点来讲解这个 product， 因为对我来说呢，它是关于一个 culture， is a piece of Chinese furniture， OK。 Another one is 做一个总结就可以了，就是记得 这是你应该有的那种 part 2大纲。我个人来说，我不会去看那个小问题，因为其实我在做这个大纲的时候呢，当你把这个 part 2说成一个故事的时候，其实已经在说那种小问题了，就是已经好好的去回答那种小问题了。所以不要太纠结那种小问题问你的是什么问题，就是依照你想说的那个故事，或者是你想说的那个direction 去把它说完， OK。 So 我们来看一看今天的这个两分钟如何把它串完。 Let's start today's 2 minutes topic. I would like to talk about a piece of furniture that is really special to me. This piece of furniture is called a rattan chair. It is a piece of traditional furniture in my countryYou will see almost every family will own a rattan product. I remember I bought it from the indigenous people when I was traveling in one of the provinces in my country. One of the reasons why I would like to talk about this piece of furniture is that it is a very important piece of furniture in my family because almost everyone in my family love using it.As I mentioned before, it is a rattan chair, so it is made of rattan. Rattan is really a good furniture material because of its lightweight, durable, weather resistant, and flexible. Especially for my grandma loves it very much. She usually uses it as a tool to read newspaper or just simply spending her time in the garden.Not only the people in my family like using it, my dog will also sometimes take a nap on this rattan chair. On the other hand, I'm a big fan of traditions and culture. When I first saw this rattan chair, it caught my eye immediately. As for me, it is a piece of Chinese furniture that was held by joinery method rather than nails, so it will require a very skillful craftsman. However, with the current technology, the introduction of the cheaper material has affected this business, especially when the younger generation are not interested in it at all. There aren't many traditional rattan makers left. So I believe that the younger generation nowadays should put in some effort and time in preserving this type of traditional product. 所以当我把这个 describe a piece of furniture 说完了过后呢，其实我就是做好这个大纲了吧，对吧？所以我就会想想我可以套入哪一些 topic。所以当我做完这个 topic 过后呢，我就会想想，诶，其实我可以串进来这个 describe a traditional product in my country， 因为是一个 traditional furniture。So another one is describe a product you bought and make you happy. So I'm really happy with the product that I bought because everyone in the family love it, as well as I'm a big fan of traditions and cultures. And then another one is about event. Describe a time you were shopping in a street market because I bought it from the indigenous people when I was traveling in the street market in one of the provinces in my country. So it's not just about the time that I was shopping. I can talk a little bit about what I bought in the street market and why I bought it, okay? So 这种的话题都可以串，比如说物体类，或者是另外一个是我买一个东西，所以这种的是购买嘛，所以都是可以这样子去串题， okay? 这就是我们的那个part 2万能串题。